to go ahead and get started. Hello, everyone. My name is Allie Petronchak. I'm a senior associate at ACP, the Veteran and Active Duty Spouse Mentoring Program. We're pleased to have you join us for today's webinar, Careers at Bristol Myers Squibb. This event is being recorded and it will be posted to our website in the coming days. Please feel free to utilize the chat box throughout the webinar to ask questions, and we ask that you stay on mute to eliminate any background noise. Bristol Myers Squibb has been partnering with ACP since 2013, and their employees have helped more than 500 ACP protégés navigate their post-military journey. We are very excited to be collaborating with them for this event. BMS is a global leading biopharmaceutical company whose mission is to discover, develop, and deliver innovative medicines that will help patients prevail over serious diseases. BMS manufactures prescription pharmaceuticals and biologics in several therapeutic areas. In 2019, BMS had 30,000 employees and generated more than $26 billion in revenue. The company works every day to transform patients' lives through scientific innovation. We have a couple great speakers lined up for today. Our speakers are Kristen McGregor, Senior Product Manager, U.S. Oncology, and former Surface Warfare Officer; Marty Whalen, Vice President, U.S. Oncology, and former Field Artillery Officer; Pat Krug, BMS Veterans Community Network Lead and former Army Medical Services Officer; Ricardo Sanchez, Associate Director, Federal Government Affairs and former Marine Corps Sergeant; and lastly, Marissa McGauley, Senior Manager of BMS Talent Acquisition. Our panel will be providing valuable insights into the company, available opportunities, and career paths. Speakers will also discuss parallels between the military and BMS careers and describe what the company looks for in a candidate. We'll open up the call to Q&A at the end, so feel free to pop in questions in the chat box throughout the presentation. And I'm now going to turn it over to Marty, who's going to do a brief introduction on the BMS. So let me just share my screen and we will get started.
All right, I see it, Allie. Thank you. And welcome, everyone. Thanks for joining us today. Great to be with you all. As Allie shared, my name's Marty Whalen. I head up our U.S. Oncology business, and I'm joined by just a terrific group of people, leaders, friends, and yes, veterans, all here at BMS. And you all need to know that we, Bristol Myers Squibb, we're both excited and very proud to be in front of you all today and share more about who we are and to explore other ways to have you all join us. That's really, you know, what we want to have as a key takeaway. We're thrilled that you're and appreciative that you're on with us today. I also want to say special thanks to ACP. To those of you in the audience, you have to know, I mean, you're navigating the workforce right now, whether you're transitioning from active duty as we speak or from the reserves or from another corporate role already. Our BMS view of American Corporate Partners, ACP, is held in the highest regard. They're an amazing, pure organization. As Allie said, we've been with them since 2013, and our commitment and involvement with them continues to grow. We really see them as best in class in terms of helping you all find great careers and, you know, just general happiness with your life, given that you have served. And on that note, on behalf of all of us, we want to say thank you for serving in some way, shape, or form this great nation. So as Allie shared, our game plan for today is pretty straightforward. I'm going to speak for about 10 minutes, just taking you through a little bit of an introduction of our great company, BMS. And once I'm done, I'll tell you a little bit about our journey. And then my colleagues with me today will share with you a little bit about their journey. And then Marissa will help wrap it up just a little bit more specifically around how you can get involved. And if you're interested, here's a place to go or there's a place to go, just so you have good opportunity for follow-up. And then, of course, as Allie mentioned, we welcome and look forward to any and all of your questions. So with that said, you know, as you guys look for that organization that you want to spend the rest of your career with, we feel we've found it here and we're really excited and proud of that. I just encourage you, you always want to look for an organization that has strong mission, vision, purpose, and values. Very similar to, I know, what was your experience in the military? And I think you have many good examples of that in the corporate setting today, but I will, yes, I have a bias. BMS is at the top of that list. So let me just tell you a little bit about what we're trying to build at BMS. And if we could advance, Allie, what we're working for here is really establishing ourselves as that leading biopharma company. And I'll talk a little bit about what that means. Our areas of therapeutic focus are very, refined to where we're all in on oncology, hematology, which is essentially blood cancer, the cardiovascular market, immunology market. Then we have some exciting things happening in the fibrotic or fibrosis market. Our purpose in everything we do, you can see on the next slide, comes back to the same thing every single time. And if you ask Ali mentioned we have 30,000 employees worldwide at BMS. If you ask any of us, what is your North Star? What is your purpose? This will be said back to you in some way, shape, or form. Our purpose are the patients who we all work for, no matter your function. And really, it sits in this vision of transforming patients' lives through science. And there's a lot to that. And we're very proud of that because to us, this is exceptionally purposeful work that gives us great motivation every single day. Our mission on the next slide, Allie touched on it, but I'll just speak to it, firsthand. It's really focused on discovery, the development, and the delivery of innovative medicines that helps patients prevail over serious and in many cases, life-threatening diseases. Healthcare is an amazing field. Some of you may be in it in some way, shape, or form today, but finding a company that's genuinely focused on, innovation to us is very important because we know how complicated the external market is. Just look at the pandemic of the last, year that we've all been operating in. And I think you've seen the healthcare sector, particularly the pharmaceutical sector, operate at its finest. And we could talk about that later on, but it's such a beautiful, powerful example of the power of science and amazing people working together to, in a rapid manner, solve some of the most complex problems. So our formal vision that you'll see on the next slide is very specific, and we want to be and plan to be, depending on how you measure it, we in some cases already are the world's leading biopharma company that transforms patients' lives through science. So it ties again the vision together around transforming patients' lives through science. Now, again, if you're on this webinar with us today, I suspect you're either looking to transition into the corporate setting and looking for a career, or maybe, as I mentioned, you're in an organization and not feeling like it's the best fit for you long term. Whatever you decide to do, I really ask you to reflect on your own values, what's most important to you, how you think, believe, act, and align that with the company's values that you look to join. And when you think about Bristol Myers Squibb, we have 6 core values that we operate under. You can see here on the next slide, not surprisingly and very intentional, we start off with integrity. We move to innovation, urgency, passion, accountability, and inclusion. Each of these values have detailed plans and initiatives underneath one of them. And we, again, pride ourselves on living these 6 values, quite frankly, both at work and in life. Our whole foundation for our business, you can see on the next slide, is to set ourselves up to be a differentiated biopharma company, again, focusing on cancer and other serious diseases. We try to be a tweener, is what we call it. There's big pharma out there, and then there's this, and big pharma is known for large resources, ability to be aggressive and active in business development, do great things for society through patient assistance, et cetera. But then there's also biotech, which is known to be extremely innovative and creative in the laboratory. They can move at lightning speed. So we call ourselves biopharma. We want to sit right in the middle of that and take the best of biotech and the best of pharma and we believe that's where BMS sits today. A little bit about our global presence, you can see on the next slide, just a view of the map. There are sites where we, you know, now everybody you can imagine is essentially virtually and working from home outside of our key laboratories and manufacturing facilities where, you know, minimal manning, but staff and I'm drawing a blank on the term, but you know, the folks that have to go in and produce the products, they obviously haven't stopped working. But under normal circumstances, we have sites in over 50 countries worldwide. So a huge footprint that we're very proud of and continues to grow going forward. And if you take a look at the next slide, our focus on product development and supply is most impressive. Now, it happens a lot. A lot of times folks from the military, when they transition out, they move into supply or operations and things of that nature. So our presence as the leading biopharma company, Bristol Myers Squibb, is very strong. And we have 20 internal manufacturing and development sites around the world doing some very cool, complex scientific advances focused on biologics, cell therapy, which is mind-blowing science, small molecule, and other product development that takes place. But if manufacturing supply isn't your focus, there are tons of other things to do at BMS too. So you can see on the next slide, we have multiple different corporate functions. It could be anchored around global business operations, HR, IT, law, corporate affairs, BD, as we mentioned. You know, I sit in the US commercial market and am heavily involved in marketing and sales and other field-based roles. So there's a lot of different things. We work with managed care companies. My point is, a great company like BMS, there is opportunity for you, no matter where your interests are. We likely, you know, have it here at this great organization. We just have to figure out if it's the right fit both ways and if the opportunity is there when you're looking. It's also important to share, you know, to stay relevant, to be innovative, to stay leading in the marketplace. Our scientists are some of the most amazing people ever, and they're always working to innovate. But we're also very actively looking externally. You can see on the next slide, business development is a key part of our strategy. And we're always looking, as are other large biopharma companies, to capitalize on great innovations that are taking place out there who need some help to commercialize and ultimately bring a new asset into the market. It's quite a process, as some of you know, in this healthcare space in the United States and worldwide. So BD is definitely a top priority, and we have a lot of irons in the fire, as you can see here on this slide. Now, take a look at the next slide. We'll look at global policy and advocacy and government affairs. This is where Ricardo works, who you'll hear from in a little bit, but tons going on across the global policy platform, both abroad as well as in the US. And we could talk about that if you have any comments or questions. Always a hot topic with healthcare. And one thing we pride ourselves on, I'll tell you a little bit more about it shortly, is that BMS, we told you that the purpose is putting the patient at the center of everything we do. The mountains we move to make sure patients in all cases can get access to our medicines is a very intense source of pride for us, where we will find a way to get them that therapy regardless of whether or not they are insured. And speaking to that, especially in this past year or so of the pandemic, amongst other stressors in society, given the social unrest that's taken place in some of the areas we know and we need to evolve to, you can see on the next slide, we've made a very bold commitment to the marketplace and to society in general, where we, Bristol Myers Squibb, along with our foundation, the BMS Foundation, has pledged over $300 million. Think about that amount in real life over the next 5 years. And we're being very intentional and public around this commitment because, candidly, the world needs it. And it needs corporate leaders to come forward and do what you're looking here on this slide. There are, no matter who's looking at it, extreme health disparities, not just in the United States, but abroad. And we are working very hard to expose those, address those, and ultimately fix those. So there's a huge effort that we're undertaking to mitigate health disparities. We also have massive investment taking place to improve diversity in our clinical trials. When we do clinical trials, it's very important to know with high prediction of accuracy what's going to take place when we get formal approval and, you know, allow that drug or compound to be used in, you know, ultimately tens of hundreds of thousands of patients. And they can't all look the same for the people that enrolled in that clinical trial. So bringing diversity to our trials is a very important strategic and necessary priority for us and society overall. And then tons of unique commitments are taking place around ensuring supplier diversity, an intense increase in our employee giving programs, and just making sure we as an organization are improving upon our workforce representation, that it is reflective of the societies and communities in which we work. Again, very important key attributes to what we're doing. So I'm talking a lot. I'm purposely going fast because I'm hoping you have some questions in your mind. I'm going to share a few more slides and then I'll start wrapping up. But there's one other very, I would say, special and unique attribute about Bristol Myers Squibb, and that is our people and business resource groups. If you ask me my two favorite things about BMS, one would be our intense focus and commitment to the patients who we ultimately serve. The second is what you're looking at here, and we call them PBRGs. And essentially at BMS, we have seven different resource groups: Be Now, Dawn, Bold, Pride, PAN, Climb, OLA, and VCN. And this conversation today is a great example of VCN, our veteran community network. But other conversations are taking place across the country and world with the other groups that you see represented here. And what's so unique about this is, yes, we have about 30,000 employees, but well over 11,000 of those 30,000 in over 45 countries are voluntarily involved in these resource groups. And we do cool stuff with these resource groups. In the veteran community, we are out in the communities. We are serving veterans on special events. We do very unique things around Memorial Day, Veterans Day, the list goes on. And that's just an organic energy that our employees who are interested in this example around the veterans, not just in our own internal workplace focus on veterans, but we do great things in the communities in which we operate. And it's a terrific source of pride, energy, and engagement that we share across all seven of these resource groups. So I thought I'd share that with you because to me, it's a very unique and distinguishing benefit of a great company like BMS. Also, our environmental stewardship, you can see we work very hard to be a sustainable, responsible company, and we certainly lead the way in many attributes, as you can see here. Wrapping up, I'm just going to close with a couple more slides. First and foremost is this key ingredient of integrity, and I want to introduce you to a couple key folks on this next slide. That first value that I mentioned, this is our CEO on the left, Dr. Giovanni Caforio, and he's a wonderful man, he's a wonderful leader, he's a wonderful person. And we have all employees across the company have taken an integrity pledge. And we say, you know, the I in integrity means what to me? And we talk about that. So to me, for example, it's always doing the right thing when no one's watching. That to me is a core, definition of integrity and character. And many people feel that way about this core value at BMS. BMS is a moving up and come, you know, it's arrived, but it's continuing to evolve and strengthen over time. You can see on the next slide, there are so many great things about why we are a great place to work. Tons of accolades that you see from some companies, key pieces on this slide that I know your panel here today is proud of is notice the military friendly employer. Both from a diversity point of view and just from an overall employer. One key example of that is for those of our employees who are still involved in the National Guard or Reserves, if they get deployed, we got them covered for up to 2 years. We will take care of their salary. We will, you know, we know they're out there protecting the freedoms of this great country. And we changed that policy just about 18 to 24 months ago. And you know, some of the collective people on this call today had a big hand in that. And it's a great source of pride. So whether, you know, it's the working mothers or the best dads or just overall being a most admired company by Fortune, it really is a great top-notch, well-respected place to be. And then you can see, again, I'll just wrap up with, you know, what's most important to us, and that is we put the patient at the center of everything we do. And I'll end it with a quote on the next slide from our CEO, Giovanni. And he, you know, this captures it well. All of us come to work every day driven by our mission, acting with a sense of urgency for our patients and their families, because there is still so much to do. And we know that while we're making great advances in science and innovation and helping people stay alive longer, in many cases, literally life-saving work, we don't and haven't found the cure to things like cancer full tilt. And we know that there's a lot of work to do. So I hope that gives you a speed round of who we are at Bristol Myers Squibb. I hope that gives you pride of who we are. And if you're interested, you know, be thinking of questions, and we'll give you a path to stay in close contact with us, because as I mentioned up front, we're very interested in meeting you as well. So now I'll transition to just telling you a little bit about our journeys, and I'll start off with myself and then I'll transition it to Kristen, but just to give you an idea of some of the different backgrounds and how we landed where we did. As mentioned, my current role is head of U.S. Oncology in the United States market and the commercial side of things. And it's a wonderful job. I love what I do. Again, it's so purposeful around bringing life-saving therapies to patients and their families who are scared and battling the evils of cancer. I've been in the industry over 20 years. I actually joined the industry as my first job leaving the Army as a field artillery officer. So I loved my time in the military. Didn't do it for, you know, the full 20 years. It was just what happened in my life at that time. My undergrad is from USMA, and I have an MBA from University of Texas. You'll find most of us love to give each other a hard time. You'll meet Ricardo, so we give him a hard time about being a Marine. He gives me a hard time about being in the Army. And then Kristen, we give her a hard time about being a Naval officer. So there's a good, healthy camaraderie that we have. And you know, to me, that's a good sign of health and fun and friendship. I'm a huge Steeler fan. I hope that doesn't offend any of you, but that's something that is very important to us and our family. And my wife, Shelley, and I have been married 25 beautiful years. Our sons seem way too old to be 23, 21, and 18. I don't know where that time went, but you know, if you have little ones, make sure you enjoy them, because they get old very quickly. So I hope you enjoyed that. Again, I'll come back on with questions going forward, but Kristen, maybe you could share a little bit about your background and why you always cheer for Army when Army plays Navy at the Army-Navy game.
I'll let that one go, Marty. Thank you. Well, thank you so much and good afternoon to all of you. My name is Kristen McGregor and my current position at BMS is a product manager in our oncology business unit under Marty Whalen on the thoracic brand team. So I started my career in the U.S. Navy after going through the NROTC program at the University of Notre Dame. I was commissioned a surface warfare officer, as Marty mentioned, and I served on two different destroyers, the USS Kincaid and the USS Fletcher. I did two sea tours with them as a strike officer in charge of the Tomahawk missiles, and then I was the assistant chief engineer. At that point, I was offered the ability to transition to a shore tour, which was at the University of South Carolina, where I led and mentored future naval officers into coming into their own at the NROTC program. After 2 years as a professor of naval science, I came to a fork in the road in my career. Was I going to rotate back to sea as a department head, or was it time for me to separate from the Navy? You know, ultimately, I made the decision to leave the military, but I was really unsure about what that path was going to look for me. You know, I had spent the previous 5 years with amazing opportunities through the U.S. Navy. And then here I was all on my own to chart my own course and move forward how I needed to. So ironically, much like you today, I actually enrolled in a TAP program also. And part of that program included a panel conversation from a medical device company. Through that conversation, I heard military veterans not just surviving, but really thriving in the civilian world. They all seemed so engaged, so challenged. And what I took away the most was so proud of the work that they were doing. So I intently listened and I took many pages of notes and I made a commitment to myself that day that I would also join a company that valued me as a veteran and the skills and capabilities that I brought to the table. My civilian career has been in some version of healthcare the whole time for the last 15 plus years. I started in medical device and moved to diagnostic. And then most recently, I've been in oncology, pharmaceuticals. My experience has been in many different functional areas. I started off in operations and then moved to supplier management. I've also worked in sales and sales leadership, and then most recently as a product manager in the oncology business unit. So I just want to leave you with one final note before I hand the floor over to my esteemed colleague, but I wanted to let you know we have all been in your shoes, and it is totally normal to feel all the emotions as you look forward to your transition. I know I personally felt excited, nervous, energized, and sometimes terrified, and it seemed like those emotions came to me all at the same time, which was so challenging to manage. But what I want to say is please take confidence in what you bring to the table. You bring a diverse background. You bring skill set that no one else has. You bring unparalleled leadership skills, and you have a can-do attitude that just gets the job done. So make sure, as Marty said, when you're looking to partner those outstanding skills and capabilities, you partner them with an outstanding company. You find one, like BMS, that understands your value, your skill set, what you bring to the table, and looks to magnify and cultivate that through development and career opportunities. So thanks so much. I look forward to our Q&A later today. And now I'll hand it over to Ricardo Sanchez.
Hey, good afternoon, everyone. Thank you, Kristen. I think that was gonna, you would think we planned this out because of the transition and what I'm gonna get into. So my name is Ricardo Sanchez. I am an associate director in the federal government affairs team. Pretty much what I do is that I assist our Senate and House lobbyists on the Democratic side, do planning, strategic planning, and carrying out our strategies to educate our Democratic policymakers and our external organizations. I love my job. I can't say that enough. Mostly because I get to do a lot of the things that I'm passionate about. I work a lot with the Tri-Caucus at the Hill, which are the minority groups within Congress. So it'll focus on the Latinos, Asians, and Black communities and policymakers. And what I love about what I'm doing is that I get to bring that back and work also with our PBRGs. As Marty was explaining earlier, it's something that's very unique to the company because we have them form part of an actual business plan. It is part of our business strategy. And to be able to do that as a living or for a living for me is fantastic. I've been with the company a total of about 3 years. And this, my career path, the way I got into BMS is exactly what Kristen was talking about. Find a company that really values what you have to offer as far as being a veteran and as far as bringing your whole self to work. In the military, I had two jobs. I served as an armor, I fixed weapons, and I was a Marine security guard. So for 3 years, I was out doing embassy security. And the reason why I kind of mix my military and civilian career into just one lump is because when I finished in my time in the Marine Corps, I wanted to become a diplomat. When I was doing the Marine Security Guard program, I saw what the Foreign Service did and I fell in love. I was like, you know what? I'm gonna get out of the military. And when I grow up, I'm gonna be a diplomat. That was my focus. So I got out, I went to school. I got my BA in Political Science and Latin American Studies from Rutgers University. And during that time, the BMS came to the Veterans Program office at Rutgers, and they wanted to create a pipeline program that put a veteran into the VCN, the Veterans Community Network, that PBRG, to intern. I was the first one, and I immediately said, absolutely, this sounds like a great opportunity. You know, it gives me a little exposure to the corporate world, something that I had no idea of. It didn't even exist, really. And in an industry that I had no knowledge about. So I went ahead and I did that. And just due to circumstance and just the fact that the leadership and the company as a whole are just fantastic, I became kind of the point person for the group. And it was without question. They were like, Ricardo, you're in charge. You take care of these programs, run with it. You need any help, you let us know. Other than that, it's all yours. And they empowered me the same way that we get empowered in the military when we get those billets, right? And we get into those leadership roles within the military. I went ahead and I did that. I continued doing the programs that we had. I was able to expand them, and I was also able to create new ones. And all in all, it's because of the great support that I had from the company and my team. I still had GI Bill money left. And, you know, again, my goal was to be a diplomat. So I said, you know what? Thank you so much, BMS and the VCN. I'm going to leave because I'm going to go to grad school here in DC because I'm going to do international affairs, a master's in international affairs. Okay, they were great. They were all very supportive. You know, sad to see me go. I went ahead and did my thing. 2 years later, the VCN leadership, they kept in contact with me. This is something, and this is a little piece of advice. Don't be like me. Do a good job at keeping in contact with those who you've worked with and who've helped you. I'm terrible at it. I think I've gotten better. And they would reach out to me. Hey, you know, just checking up on you every month, every 2 months. So when I graduated, I was, you know what? Let me tell them that I graduated because they helped me get through this, because they were there and they asked me, they offered any help. And as soon as I wrote that email, the first question I got was, do you need a job? I was like, yes, I definitely need a job. I was burnt out, of course, from grad school. I was like, you know what? I'm going to give myself 2 weeks. I'm just going to sit on my couch and just be a couch potato. But as soon as I got that email, practically right after I graduated, you know, I did it. I went ahead and I applied for it. I got the internship here in DC, so I didn't have to go anywhere. I didn't really have to change anything with the Federal Government Affairs Group. And then, as you can see from the slide, I did a 4 month stint as an intern. They didn't want to let me go, and they had an opening as a consultant. So I did 50-50 work. Some of it was policy and the other half was administrative. And it comes also a little bit, shows that they value what we do, and we're just, you know, we're go-getters. We'll do whatever we have to do. So I didn't mind doing the admin work because it gave me more exposure. And then after a while, my boss in the DC office was like, Ricardo, I know that you're waiting, because I was waiting for a job with the State Department. I know you're waiting for this job, and I know you're being transparent about it, but you don't want to take a job with us because you're waiting for this. But you know what, Ricardo? We want you to take the job. The skills that you have and the work ethic that you have are second to none. We want you in our team. Down the line, if you decide to leave and go to the State Department and follow your dream, you know, go for it. Go ahead and do it. But at least take this opportunity and see where it goes. And if it wasn't for that support that I've received from up and down, from a job here, from my team here, and all those back in New Jersey when I entered in 2016, I wouldn't feel comfortable taking this role. Especially, again, my entire background was on international affairs. I was thinking outside policy. You know, but here I am, I'm still doing policy, but now it's pharma policy. So again, I want to emphasize how much attention and how much focus and appreciation they have for the skills that veterans bring. And just a couple of little fun facts. I mean, I'm in the gym all the time. I was actually born outside of the United States. I'm originally from Cali, Colombia, and I'm a first generation BA and MA. So it just shows what we have to offer as veterans. And with all that, I'm gonna go ahead and pass it over to my good friend, Pat.
Thank you, Ricardo. Awesome. So my name's Pat Krug. I'm the lead for the Veterans Community Network at BMS. Marty talked about PBRGs a little bit earlier, but I want everyone to stop just for a minute and think about what we just covered. And think about specifically the profiles that you just heard and think about them really in the basic sense. Marty, field artillery officer to the lead for oncology at BMS. You look at Kristen. She was a surface warfare officer and a couple different jobs within the Navy, and now she's actually heading up product line at a biopharma company. Ricardo just told you his story. I mean, he was an armor, also a security guard, and now look at him. He's a lobbyist. He's a diplomat, essentially. He's lived his dream, and if you take a look at mine, not so different than their stories. I was a medical services officer in the United States Army. I'm now leading the Veterans Community Network at BMS, attached to basically the Global Diversity and Inclusion arm within Bristol Myers, just so we can make sure that as an organization, we stay on task in our mission to understand and to make sure that folks understand the value of a veteran. So we'll talk about some of the things that we're focused on at VCN and within BMS, but I just want you to hear those stories because I know a lot of you, and I have a protege that I'm working with an ACP as well. It's hard to make the mental leap to what's next. But believe me, when you take your skills and you look at the transferable skills and what you all are able to do and what you've done already, those skills are transferable. The discipline, the work ethic, it's a theme you heard through all the different profiles. And think about yourself, and I really want you to and encourage you to dig deeply into the opportunities at BMS, other companies, and see where those transferable skills line up. Because believe me, there is a place for people like you all who have that discipline and that drive to succeed. So also would love a little bit of feedback in the chat room if you get an opportunity. Who is blown away by the fact that I've been out of the Army for over 27 years? That's probably mind-boggling to a lot of you. Love to see some support in the chat room if you believe that. If you don't believe it, go ahead and hold your comments. But I've been with BMS for about 3 years. I was with AstraZeneca, another biopharma company, 24 years prior to that. Quite honestly, this is the best move I've ever made because one of the things that we're stressing as part of the mission of the PBRGs and what I love about Bristol Myers Squibb specifically is the culture. It's about the culture here. It's about making sure that you can be your authentic self, making sure that as a veteran, if you come over to BMS or as a reservist or National Guardist, you feel supported and you understand that we have your back. We're working on policies to make sure this is the best place possible for you to work. And you find that role that adds that work-life balance that you're looking for and the mission and purpose that Marty outlined whenever he started the call. So it to me is a beautiful intersection of all those things. Just to touch on my military time, again, Army Medical Services Officer. I was with the 4th Infantry Division, 3rd Brigade Combat Team. Kind of funny, like a lot of you all, you know, I heard, oh, medical service officer, heck, I'm going to be a hospital administrator. But the Army has different plans for us all. The Navy has different plans. And they attached me to an infantry division. Best thing that ever happened to me in the Army as well. My education came from the Virginia Military Institute as undergrad. I got a master's degree a little bit later on at a local university. And some fun facts. And I want to stress this first fun fact. I live on Krug Road near my family farm where I grew up. And Jerry, love the comment that you're slightly older than my career. I appreciate that. But I wanted to focus on that, the fact that I live in central Pennsylvania, because the blessing of the pandemic is there are opportunities for you that there have never been previously because of the ability to work virtually and work from home, and to add flexibility if you're willing to travel a little bit. So understand, and you saw the map that Marty put up, we have facilities all over the nation. But also understand that if you're willing to travel a little bit, most of you don't have a problem with overnights. You've been living them for the past several years, I'm sure. But if you're willing to travel, you can actually try to make things work in a major company like BMS. And I'm a living testament to that. So I just wanted to stress that. I'm a Steeler fan as well. So go Steelers there. Sorry, again, if there's any Raven fans out there. But I also wanted to say that as blown away as you all are and the fact that I've been out of the Army for so long, my son's also, he just completed his active duty commitment with the Army. He was a 82nd Airborne guy. Yes, he calls me a leg at the dinner table, but he's moved back to home. He actually did a little time in Afghanistan, and I know what it's like. I have a wife and two additional grown daughters who served with us. They were there when the deployments happened. We know what you went through as a family. And we also know that for a lot of you, balance and work-life balance is super important. So I started the conversation off by just talking about that transition, making sure you can picture yourself taking the next step. And I want to really impress upon you, finding your mission and your purpose as your next step is of the utmost importance. Whatever we can do to help you do that, we're happy to do it. I just want you to explore BMS. The culture here is second to none. I think you'd love it if you came over. With that in mind, I'm going to toss it over to Marissa Magali, and she's going to walk us through the next steps.
Thank you, Pat. It is nice to meet everyone. As a quick introduction of myself, I don't have an about me slide because I am not a veteran, but I am very grateful to all of you for your service. I work on the talent acquisition team here at BMS. Specifically, I lead recruiting for our manufacturing department. So manufacturing, supply chain, you know, quality, everything like that. So if you're interested, let me know. I am an ACP advisor, so you can always reach out to me on the website. So just wanted to talk through a few roles. I know we had a few questions about what roles are available for people coming out of the service. So of course, manufacturing that I touched on, these are all roles where we have actually hired veterans into. So just some examples, but I think, you know, there's boundless options. So we have manufacturing associates that are on the floor working with the product at all levels. You know, there's leadership roles within that department as well. Compliance, logistics, same thing. I did see a question before around if you had a nursing degree. So we actually do have a role within our environmental health and safety department, which is what EHS stands for, which is an occupational health nurse, which is someone that does sit on site, especially at our manufacturing facilities, checking things like vision and things like that for people that will be working on the floor. We have some roles in quality around sample management, document control, microbiology, which is kind of like checking the temperature of a room and making sure it's at the right levels for the product that we're making in that department. Training, of course, is a lot of training done in the military, a lot of training done in our industry too. So if you've ever had experience designing training curriculums or anything like that, that could be a good option. Next slide, Allie, please. And then as a few people touched on, of course, commercial is a great option. Lots of opportunities within the commercial department. A lot of people on this call went in that direction, so they can kind of speak to you about that. We do have the facilities and engineering department if you have an interest in the engineering track, also in maintenance or facilities. Project management, enabling functions, which I'm in the enabling function kind of group. So that covers like legal, IT, HR, so just a few options there. If you go to our career site, we do actually have a specific landing page for veterans, which will bring up all of the opportunities that are currently available. So if you wanted to go to look to that after, that is there. You can also join our talent community. You'll see that on the veterans landing page right at the bottom, where you can sign up for alerts for new roles. If you don't see anything in the area of interest, we can make sure to let you know first when those opportunities do become available so that you can go right ahead and look there. Next slide, please. So Marty touched on this, but this is just a really quick overview and sorry if it's a little blurry, it was copy and pasted. You can also find benefits information on our career site as well. But just wanted to touch on some of our really amazing specific benefits for veterans. So as he mentioned, we do have the 24 months of paid leave if you get called to active duty. As of this year, we actually added an additional benefit, which is an additional 2 weeks of time off as you transition back to civilian life from your active duty. And then we do have actually a similar 2 week leave for family care military. So if you have someone in your family that's getting called to active duty, we have that 2 week period too, where you can help them transition. So a lot of great benefits, a lot of great benefits beyond that too. So feel free to go to our website and review those. I can of course send more information as well. Next slide. Marty also touched on this slide, but I know there were some questions around locations and if you could work in Europe or different places. So as you can see, we do have sites all over the world. So if you have an interest in working in Europe, working in the US, working in South America, you know, there's a lot of different options. So you can kind of sort by location on our careers page as well, if there's a specific country of interest that you want to work in. So just wanted to kind of reiterate this from Marty's slide earlier. Next slide. And then this was already talked on a few times, but just it's one of the things I love most about BMS as well. I'm actually a member of BNOW and the VCM. So you can be part of more than one people and business resource group if you have interest there. You don't have to be a veteran, as you know, I am not a veteran to join, or you don't have to be any of these groups if you want to join, you just want to be an advocate there. I am the TA lead for the VCN. So if you ever joined BMS, we would probably, you know, get to know each other there. But just another great thing, I know this has already been talked about, but it's a really great thing that BMS has. So just wanted to revisit it again. And then this again too, just, I know Marty already talked about this as well, but you know, it is a really great place to work. I have actually been here for about a year and a half. I actually came back to BMS. I used to work for a company called Juno Therapeutics, which is now a BMS company. So it all kind of came full circle. So it is a really great place to be. I feel really supported, especially this last year has been a bit crazy for everyone with the pandemic. And I felt supported throughout that process. They've definitely, you know, done the right things for the team. And I can touch on some of that in the questions later too, if anyone has questions. I know there was some about remote work, but other than that, I think that was all of my slides. So we can open it up for questions.
Perfect, thank you, Marissa. I'm just gonna flip back a couple slides to where the links were to the careers page and BMS talent community. Feel free to look all these folks up on LinkedIn. ACP AdvisorNet is our online community. We have tons of BMS advisors on that site as well. It's a good place to network with some employees at BMS. And lastly, if you are an ACP protege or an alumni, or if you recently applied to ACP, we have many, many, many BMS mentors in the program, like Pat and Marty, who are more than willing to connect with you. So feel free to reach out to your ACP point of contact. We can help facilitate those connections. I'll also post my email address in the chat box in a little bit. If you want to reach out to me, feel free. I'm going to take down the slides and we'll open it up for questions. And there was a question in the chat box that I think I'll start with. About upward mobility and leadership paths at BMS. I'm thinking maybe Marty could be the person to address that and share a little bit about that.
There we go. I did see that question, Allie. So thanks for pulling that forward. So two things I'd say. I'm gonna answer the question, but I'm also gonna add a little bit to it because they're connected. One thing you all can't underestimate is what you have. Kristen spoke about it in her comments. The skills, the experiences, and your abilities translate far more than I think you think they do into the civilian world, okay? And you'll never really know that until you make these transitions, specifically leadership, mission mindset, teamwork, inclusion. All these things are very powerful traits that are just ingrained in you from your military experience that you don't know how powerful and helpful those are to any organization you join. Let's face it, the world is not long on leadership. We all will always need new, strong leadership in any organization, in any industry. Bristol Myers Squibb is no different. So we're always looking for people who can help others come together, achieve a common goal for the right purpose, and move forward. So you ask about upward mobility. The answer is there's tons of upward mobility. We have 30,000 employees. We have a revenue generating company of $42 billion a year. And you see that we're all over the globe. But the job to join us, it won't be easy. Like what you're doing right now is a major step. You have to be on your game. You have to be the best. You have to be persistent and patient at the same time, while trying to learn how to network and navigate a wonderful company like BMS. Doing what we're doing right now is a beautiful first step. Connections to links, connections to us. Marissa will help you navigate in greater detail as we go forward, but it's still not going to be easy. It's quite a process, and it needs to be, because we're a growth-oriented company, and that's a good thing. But there is room for you here. There's plenty of room for you here in upward mobility and across many different functions. But I cannot underestimate that the skills that you have learned and experienced translate far better than I promise you you're giving yourself credit for. Be confident and comfortable with that. Your relationship with your ACP mentor is a powerful one. As Allie said, I think I'm on my sixth protege, and I always prioritize that, because to me, it's a small way of giving back is in my adult life. It's like one small thing I can do. I will make time for that. And there are thousands of us doing that for ACP in partnership with ACP across many different companies. That's why we love the organization so much. So you're on to something really good. Leverage it, and we will help you transition successfully, hopefully here.
Perfect. Thank you, Marty. And another question I have that was from the pre-submitted questions that we received prior to the event is for Marissa. What can a veteran do to stand out in the interview process and the hiring process?
Yes, great. I'm not on mute. Okay, perfect. Great question. I'd say there's a few things. You know, one is, you know, I think preparation is always a key part of an interview. So whether it's BMS or another organization, you know, doing your research before you go into an interview. One, this benefits you as well. Like, why do you want to work there? Kind of learning about the organization. Does its values align with your values? But being able to speak to that with the interview team and show that you have kind of done that research up front. I would say even in this virtual environment, you know, body language, eye contact, still very important. You know, we're not shaking hands anymore right now, unfortunately, but hopefully we'll get back to that at some point. But another critical piece, I would say, do come prepared with questions for the interviewer. Always good to at least ask one question. You know, a good question to ask. You can always ask about the culture of the company, so you know if it's a place where you really want to be as well. And then I think one just point of advice too is, you know, we have our own jargon within the biotech industry. I know the military has some jargon as well. So I think just being careful about abbreviations that you're using in an interview, because the interviewer might not be familiar. So if you are using them, just making sure you're clarifying what you mean. And then I'd say the final piece is just looking through the job description. You know, you probably won't have exactly everything on there, just like any other external candidate might not as well, but just what transferable skills have you gained that are kind of similar to that job description? And you, if you need help kind of navigating that, a lot of my TA colleagues are on the ACP advisor list as well. So you can reach out to us and we're happy to help you navigate that.
Perfect. Marissa, can I jump in and Ellie, just because Matthew Dalton asked a great question that I think is very pertinent, and it actually leans into the question that you just answered as well. His question was, how does BMS value military rules when it comes to meeting qualifications on the job postings? And so what you just talked about was when you're in the interview, what Matthew's asking about specifically is, how do I get to the interview knowing that I don't necessarily or may not meet 100% of those qualifications as they're written? And I'll tell you, Matthew, I love the question, and it's a work that we're actually very focused on as part of the VCN and as part of Bristol Myers Squibb. We want to make sure that we do a really good job of translating your skills and abilities to so that we understand how well those transferable skills match up. And quite honestly, there's work to be done there, and we're working on it. We're working with some of our hiring managers. Marissa can tell you a story where we just hired a bunch of veterans at the Devens, Massachusetts facility, where we went in with a company beforehand and actually trained the hiring managers so that they were well versed on how do we make sure that we're looking at these skills in the right way if they don't match up fundamentally with all the different things that we're requiring. So I'm going to hand it off to Marissa just to speak to that, but I just want to encourage everybody, you don't have to match 100%. Take a look at it. If you looks like that you match up very well, we have ways of making sure we evaluate that talent purely. So Marissa, you can add some context to that in light of the Devens hiring event.
Yeah, of course. So as Pat mentioned, we recently held a veterans recruitment event in March, actually. And we hired 18 veterans from the event for that site. The focus of the roles was in manufacturing, supply chain, and quality. And we hired individuals across all of those three different areas. As Pat mentioned, we did actually go through a training with the hiring team with an organization called Psych Armor, where they went through something called the 15 things veterans want you to know. And so it kind of talked about exactly what Pat mentioned, about kind of how to read a veteran's resume, how to learn what skills are transferable, also to alleviate any preconceived biases that might be coming into the interview. So really kind of helping through that process. And, you know, I think a lot of roles like supply chain, as Odin was kind of talking about in the chat here, supply chain roles are very similar in the military to kind of what you'd be doing here at BMS. It might be a different product line, of course, but you know, a lot of that is very transferable over. And so kind of teaching the team here at BMS, you know, what skills to look for there, aside from just specifically those words saying exactly what you need. We do those on a regular basis as well, and we'll continue to do that moving forward. But our teams are continually going through those trainings to learn how they can, you know, better support the veteran community. And bring your great talent to BMS, of course.
Perfect. And we did just get two more questions in the chat box. I'm going to address Jerry's question about internship programs with universities. And maybe that's something that Marissa could speak to, any internships at BMS.
So we do have internships, and I keep referring back to our careers page, but we do have a specific, if you go to our careers page, there's an early in career box that you can check, and it'll actually bring up all the timelines of when we open up our internship opportunities, when we close them out, what that looks like. You can also search for the different internship opportunities. As far as partnering specifically with ASU, I'm not 100% sure if that's in place or not. We do have an early in careers team that sits within the talent acquisition function, so could connect with them on that, but would definitely as a starting point recommend going to that early in careers page to at least review the timelines and see what's open, if there's anything left. I know we're at that point now where a lot of the summer internships are probably already filled, but we'll be kind of recruiting again for, you know, future semesters. So more to come there.
Perfect, thank you. We are just up on the hour, so I want to thank everyone from BMS who spoke on the call and helped plan. Thank you for everyone for attending. So this is being recorded. It'll be up on our website. I encourage everyone to connect on LinkedIn and join ACP AdvisorNet if you have not. If you have any questions or feedback from this event, please feel free to reach out to me. We are here to serve you. So if there's any way that we can improve our current programming, we want to hear from you. I hope everyone has a terrific rest of your days and weeks, and we'll see you next time. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Thanks all.